How about, is there anybody in this room who has a business right now who is not quite making enough money? Hands up nice and tall. You actually own the business? Is that right? If you actually are the business owner and you're not making really the profits you want to make right now. Nice and high. Nice and high. Okay, what do you sell, my friend? Electronic components. All right. So do you run the business? Okay. Do you want to come up on stage here? Come on down. Please welcome this gentleman to the stage. What's your name?
Larry.
Welcome, Larry. Just come up over on the side here, my friend. Thank you for coming on up. So you have a business, Larry, all right?
Yes.
Okay, what's the business? Tell the audience.
It's North Texas Distributors.
North Texas Distributors, and what do you do?
We sell closed-circuit TV to wholesalers.
Closed-circuit TV to wholesalers. And who are those wholesalers? Like just other shops which sell them to customers?
The installers.
Okay. So how's business?
Poor.
Poor. How poor?
Very poor.
Poor enough for you to be here because you want another option. Is that right?
That's right.
Okay. So listen, here's the question. Why should I do business with you over anyone else? Whenever you're ready, you just give us your answer.
Because I can give you the personal attention that you deserve.
Right. So you give us personal attention. Do you want to buy from him yet?
No.
Ooh, harsh audience. Harsh audience. Yeah, Larry. Right. So you give us the personal attention that we deserve. Right. So can we get personal attention from anywhere else?
Yes.
Right, so, okay, got a bit of a problem there, Larry.
Yes, we do.
Why should I do business with you over anyone else? Because you're saying that whatever I can get from you, I can get from somebody else.
That's great.
So why should we do business with you? Because right now, you're all potential customers, all right? This is our business here, and he wants you to be his customer. So, come on, what do you got there, my friend?
You can use my experience and my knowledge about the product to be able to do the job and to be able to not have problems and to be able to not have to learn it yourself through experience. You can use my experience to help your job go easier, to help the installs go smoother, and to ultimately make yourself more money.
Okay. So does anybody else have experience out there, Larry?
Yes. But you can't get them on the phone.
Oh, really? We can't get them on the phone. Why can't we get them on the phone?
Because they're the upper echelons. They're not working the sales counters. And generally, these people
now, hold
work
on,
the sales
Larry.
Counters.
You mean I cannot phone anyone else in the USA to try and buy these closed-circuit televisions?
If you could find them, yeah.
So if I can find them, I can phone them up. They will not answer that phone.
Oh, they will answer it. They may not.
So, now, hold on. So they will answer the phone?
Yes, they will.
But, so when they answer the phone, they don't have the experience. Is that what you're saying?
That's correct.
So you guarantee me, if I phone someone right now, they will answer the phone, but they will not have the experience?
I don't guarantee it.
All right. Can you see a problem here?
Yes.
Are you buying his product yet?
No.
Now, it's becoming very obvious to me, Larry, why your business is poor. Can you see that?
Yes.
Because can you see, folks, that at the moment he cannot answer this question? He cannot truly answer this question? Has he given you a reason yet?
No.
Which makes him unique?
No.
Folks, are you awake? I need you to answer me, all right? Good. You're talking like crazy. You're fantastic, yes. So let's get serious, Larry. Why should we do business with you over anyone else?
I don't know.
You don't know? Isn't that a hard thing, folks? To not know? Now, is Larry unique, do you think? Do you think Larry's the only one with this problem? I'm the only person who does this worldwide on any stage with any person anywhere, and this is the same problem every single time someone comes on stage, so you're not unique there, my friend, all right?
Well, good.
So this is a normal problem to have, normal challenge to have, right? So come on, Larry, let's get serious. Truly, are you good at what you do?
Yes.
How good?
Very good.
Well, how good?
On a scale or what?
Yeah, between 0 and 10, where are you?
Probably 8.
An 8 out of 10. That's pretty good. So is there anybody else out there who's as good as you, do you think?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes. So other people have got the good knowledge.
Yes.
So therefore, we can't go to that area, I would think.
Okay.
Because we have competitors. So why did you start the business?
I enjoy teaching people how to do it.
You enjoy teaching people how to do it?
Helping them to make money and helping them in their business.
Yeah, you enjoy that. That's what you really do it for. Right. Is that a good reason? Yeah, that's right. It's a great reason. You obviously care enough about that, right?
Yes.
So how do I know you care? If I come to your business, how do I know you care?
I'm attentive and try to solve your problem and listen to whatever you tell me.
Yes. Is that enough, folks?
No.
It's not enough. Can you hear that straight away?
Am I getting close, guys?
We're getting there, don't you worry. See, they want the service for Larry. What they're saying is, you know, just they expect what you're saying. They expect you to look after. They expect you to have knowledge. They expect to get pleasant service. Am I right? Yes or no? Yeah, they expect that. What we need to find is, why should we do business with you over going to somebody else who probably will give us the same sort of service? What do you think it could be?
I don't know.
You don't know? If you don't know, then what could it be?
It could be because my prices are better. It could be...
Are your prices better?
No.
No. Well, it's probably not going to be that. We probably will eliminate that one then. Okay.
It could be because I'm convenient and local.
You're convenient and local, okay, which is handy. Which is handy for us.
It could be because they have the ability to run a charge account with me.
Uh-huh. So we can buy stuff, but we don't have to pay for it till the end of the month.
Right.
Uh-huh.
I'm about out.
What can they get from you that can't get anywhere else?
The question from the audience is, what can they get from you that can't get from anybody else?
Probably nothing, other than the convenience.
I think it might have been onto something when you said that you were available or reachable.
Yes.
And I think there's something in that when you can actually talk to somebody that might be able to say yes instead of only give no answers.
Right, so the general statement is that because you're available by phone, that's a good reason. But we did establish, didn't we, that we can actually phone somebody else and find that sort of service. True?
It's hard to find.
It's hard to find, but can we do it? All right.
He's at the top of the company, so if you can get,
you
know, above a certain level, a lot of times when you call a company, you can only get people that can tell you no.
Yeah, you get employees rather than the manager, yeah. Mm-hmm. So is that really important to you, to talk to the manager rather than the staff? Yeah, so that's pretty good. They're telling you that's pretty good. Yeah. What do you got, my friend?
He said it earlier. He said he listens to them.
We listen to them. Yeah. So hold on. Let me just hold on one second, folks. And thank you very much. You're doing fantastic, all right? The audience is telling you they like the fact that you listen to them. Do you feel that most people, most shops don't really listen to you?
Yeah.
Is that what you're telling me? Okay, so probably a fairly general yes to that question, right? So if you are someone who actually listens to solve their problems, that could be something they might want. Now, to you, it's just a matter of fact. That's how you run your business.
Right.
In your advertising, do you mention anything about that?
No.
Really? Could it be possible that you're the only person who truly listens to your problem?
It could be.
Yeah. But truly, do you think that's true? It's either a yes or a no, pretty much.
In the whole world,
right.
No.
So that's not our USP. Am I making sense? Yeah. So why should we? Come on, get serious, Larry. Why did you start the business? Why are you going there every day? What are you doing different? Why should we come to you? Are you going there? Are you starting earlier, ending later? Why should we do business with you?
Once again, because I'm convenient. And because I offer products that the customer needs.
Yeah.
And that I help them with their business, become a partner with them, almost.
What's that?
Become a partner.
What's that? You become a partner with who?
With my customers.
With your customer. What does that mean, Larry?
That means I treat their business as if it was mine.
Really? The audience is telling you something pretty powerful. You treat their business like it's yours. Do you want to buy his product now?
Yeah.
Can you hear the big yes there, Larry?
Yes, I do.
How do you feel now?
Much better. Business is getting better already, I can tell.
And what if we were to put on your business card, on your newspaper ads, on your website, the only closed circuit TV dealer in America who guarantees to make your business his business?
That's good.
Congratulations. Well done. Thank you. Just about it.
You'll have to pay you for that.
That one's on the house, all right? Yeah, that's free. What do you think of that? Powerful stuff. One question. Keep on asking that question until you get it.